This is a fantastic show. It's called Conversations in LA. We're going to get to that. But first, a conversation in Montreal, Canada. Lou Diamond Phillips is making a movie up there with Jennifer Tilly. And then what happens? Or would you like Mark to tell the story?
Well, Mark seems to remember it better than I do.
Okay.
I remember the club. And they used to have a great jazz trio, as I recall.
Yeah.
And spent a lot of time at the blistering winters there.
Yeah, you were there at the wrong time.
It was up to like, 6 feet.
Yeah.
It was ridiculous.
Yeah.
You had to go through like little gopher burrows to get anywhere.
We had a good time, though.
It was wonderful. Yeah, I loved it. Honestly. Well,
there you go. Anyway, enough about the beverage habits. But let's meet Anne-Marie Phillips, who, along with Lou, this show is called Conversations in L.A. Anne-Marie, you wrote it. You created it. You are featured in it. There's an episode with Lou in it. Why did this come to your attention?
This came to my attention. I have to give a shout-out to Jamie and Christy, our casting directors. They saw me in Goliath, which I was in the last season.
I love Goliath.
Thank you. Yeah.
Goliath
and
is great.
They went, "Oh God, Lou's got to do our show." And they called Anne-Marie Cummings, our creator. They mentioned my name and they said, "Oh, hey, what a nice idea." They called and I was immediately intrigued because Conversations in LA is a 30-minute streaming show, but it's shot in one take.
Oh wow.
One continuous take, no cuts. So it speaks to my theater background. It's like, okay, this is a little one-act play. Also, a big shout-out to Sebastian Heinrich, our cinematographer. It is literally this dance that Anne-Marie, as a director, choreographs for 30 minutes. And when you start, that's just it. There is no safety net.
So if I make a mistake in the 22nd minute,
then we start over.
Oh.
Yeah, no, it's, my background is the theater. I've been working as an actress or a playwright, as an artistic director, and when I moved to LA about 4 years ago, all of this came together with these one-take episodes. So each episode, it's Conversations in LA. Each episode is a conversation. I work with my DP, Sebastian Heinrich, and we use a Sony A7R II gimbal. And so every episode has very detailed choreography, and it takes us a month per episode because of the detailed work that we do. And then we bring in the actors. It's all very sequential, very specific kind of work.
And what's it about?
It's about an older woman who meets a younger man, a much younger man, and they fall in love. And Gustavo,
I'm not the younger man.
Gustavo Velasquez plays my counterpart. I met him just randomly when I was here as I was writing Conversations in LA. We were at a Starbucks. We met. I just went up to him and I said, "You kind of look like you might be the role." And I auditioned him the next day and I'm like, "You got it."
Oh,
and it was just this very spur of the moment kind of thing. But Lou came in. I saw Lou on Goliath and that was it for me. And then, of course, I got to know more, his more recent work with Longmire and The 33 with Antonio Banderas, and I was just sold. I said, "Jamie Christie, he's it. He's in."
5 Daytime Emmy nominations, including a Daytime Emmy nomination for Lou. Watch this. Look.
What you're saying is you never test the drugs out. You never take a little for yourself when no one's looking?
I already said no.
Wait a minute. So you're not surprised? You're not at all surprised that it was me who answered the door?
No.
Really?
Maybe at first a little.
At first, and just a little.
Yeah.
Wait a minute,
hey,
young
you
man.
Have what you need. I
I'm
have what
not
I need.
Done
I'm
talking
well, I'm
to
done
you.
I'm done talking to you, man.
Put it back!
Okay, see, that play's so extraordinarily real. That's why.
Exactly. That's and why that's so the beauty. Well, first of all, it speaks to the musicality of her dialogue. I was blown away. It's like Tarantino, it's like Mamet, it's wonderful. And when you're going to do it in one take, you cannot. It has to be structured, it has to be so well defined that it pulls you along. I have to say about this take, and I'm going to give a shout out to Gustavo Velasquez's dad, who I know is watching this.
Yes,
he's a big fan of yours. So the take that actually makes it to streaming was the fourth take. We had a great take right before lunch, busted a third take. Now in this, Gustavo has to guzzle a bunch of fake beers. So by the time we get to the fourth take, this man, young man, is topped off.
Right.
And at one point he guzzles basically a ginger ale, and then he's supposed to burp. So we're about 16 minutes into the take. He goes to burp and throws up. And in my mind, I'm thinking, we're 16 minutes in, man. I am not busting this take. This is the one. We're going to keep on going. And so I grabbed the towel and just kept acting. And he's looking at me, and I can see the cinematographer like, really?
Okay. I'll go with it. Wow.
Conversations in L.A., available to stream now on Amazon Prime. If you do a Conversations in Montreal, you'll have to include Mark.
Absolutely. You're in.
We'll jump back here in just a minute. Nice to see you.
Thank you, guys. Thank you.